I think it's quite special, actually. I don't think there were a lot of projects that did this kind of combination with classical Arabic music and classical Western music. And I think the roles are also really, in a way, they're similar. You know, they're all in love. They're all trying to sacrifice for their loved ones, and they all end up, you know, suffering and the good stuff.
Yeah, and for me personally, I kind of never heard Arabic music like that, like live with those artists. And it is a very beautiful meeting for me. I just discovered so many things about singing thanks to them, actually. Mm. Yeah. Yeah.
With Arabic music, it's not, for example, as big, in like volume-wise, for example, as opera singing is. Mm-hmm. So, and that's a lot of also technique, how to fill the stage and still do this, you know, the traditional Arabic stuff, but also try to deliver it in a way that is also similar to the Western way of doing that. Normally, it's a lot of improvisation. It's like music that's really improvisation-based. But in this opera, because you need to make the combinations, that was also one of the challenges, was to really try to find a balance between, mm-hmm. you know, the improvisation and also the planned stuff and the rehearsed stuff and, you know, that you already know before.
Yeah, that's kind of opposite because everything is always written for us. I am very used to the written music, and sometimes I would like to do more into this way of improvisation, and because there are so many notes you do, mm-hmm. which are. Because I'm created from the moment, it's really incredible.